One of the great things about coming to the Chet Atkins Appreciation Society is the new pickers you get to hear, or the guests you get to see and meet. This year, it's a guitar. Not just any guitar, it's a one-of-a-kind in the world guitar. It was a prototype. It was Chet Atkins' favorite tinker toy guitar. And you're gonna get to see it and hear all about it. Ladies and gentlemen, meet Dark Eyes.
This is Chet Atkins' guitar. Back in 1956, actually, he played it on the Grand Ole Opry as well. And this is the what we call a Dark Eyes prototype. And certainly, people have to know what this guitar was to Gretsch.
More importantly, it's the guitar that sealed the deal between Gretsch and Chet Atkins.
In reality, this guitar is the guitar that changed everything in the 6120 category.
He had been playing some of their instruments with the F hole, and now, you got to remember, this is the early 50s. Now he's starting to use amplifiers, and they're standing close to them. So he's starting to get it, it's starting to howl, you know, and he's getting feedback.
This is what we call a seal top guitar, which is really the top of this guitar is about, you know, about 3/8 of an inch thick.
He asked them to make a guitar that didn't have any F holes.
It's actually no holes in the guitar at all. These F holes are very unique in the sense that they're actually cutouts from drum material that Gretsch had, and then they messed those off so they could paint the guitar black, and then that would be noticeable as gold sparkle F holes, but there are no F holes.
Then he, of course, because Chet was a tinkerer, him and Ray Buck started changing the pickups and trying different things, and you know, just to get what he was looking for.
And the other interesting thing is about these pole pieces, these magnets in the fingerboard, they actually were drilled through with a drill press straight into the top, going inside long enough so that you could put little coils on those to find out what the proper harmonic place would be for this phantom bass, as he called it. And it was really something else. They experimented extensively with that, but they realized that someone else had come up with a bass divider type unit, which was all electronic rather than analog, as this would be with real magnets and coils.
And I'm so glad that Tom Doyle has restored it to its original way. The only thing I noticed was that Chet's unusual vibrato arm is still on it, you know. So if it was my guitar, I would go back to the Bigsby arm because it works for me. But Chet had a particular style of vibrato arm that he used to use. When he used it on other instruments, I couldn't play them. I'd have to get it out of the way, you know, to play Chet's guitar.
I think I've covered pretty much everything about it. It's really a treasure that was given to me by a gentleman named Scott Chinnery. Scott Chinnery was one of the largest collectors of American guitars. This guitar was at the Smithsonian, as a matter of fact.
But this guitar is so important. I mean, it really sealed the deal, and it started that whole era of Gretsch electric guitars, 6120s and all that. And everybody wanted to get that sound, and that's why that guitar is so important.
Scott Chinnery was very, very nice to me, and he said, Tom, he said, I want you to take that Martin, and I want you to take that D'Acquisto, that D'Angelico, and take the Gretsch guitar back to your shop. And I said, well, what do you want done on this guitar? He said, well, nothing. I said, well, why do you want me to take it back to my shop? He says, I'm giving it to you today for you to take care of. And I just was flabbergasted. He said to me, look, Tom, you have the connection between Les and Chet like no one else that I know. and I know it would be in your good hands, and you love what this guitar represents. It was about 17 years ago, and so I've had it that long, and brought it back down here to Cass to show all the great guitar players and let them hold it, take pictures, and play it.
Sure enough.
So this is very
interesting. Oddly enough, the cover of that, though, if he's playing this guitar, the cover is shot with the red one.
Yeah, that's correct. But if you look on other albums, you'll see this guitar in the background facing backwards. He didn't want anybody to see what he's actually doing.
Oh, is that what he was selling? You're already in this thing. All I have to do is stand here and go like this and it comes out.
I think this guitar should be in the Country Music Hall of Fame, where Chet's legacy really lives, you know. And people come from all over the world to Nashville to go to the Country Music Hall of Fame. It's the Holy Grail.
I hope that eventually the Country Music Hall of Fame will acquire this instrument.
But that guitar is a really important, iconic instrument that deserves to be in that special place and for the world to come and see.
The home for this guitar is in the Country Music Hall of Fame.
BDTV.